Hi everybody, this is Meaghan Anderson, Iowa State University Extension and Outreach Field Agronomist here in Central Iowa. I'm actually standing out in a cornfield here. Hopefully you can see this. This actually has a little bit of a carryover issue from a herbicide called Fomesafen. We will occasionally see carryover from our soybean year to our corn year with this herbicide, in particular when we have really late applications of that herbicide post-emergence, or especially when we have it in combination with really dry conditions, which we actually had here in parts of Central Iowa last summer. And so we expect to maybe see a little bit of this showing up in overlap areas or areas where perhaps a higher rate of the herbicide was applied, like on field edges, where maybe the sprayer was just starting to spray or just slowing down and stopping spraying. You could see here, hopefully, that some of this corn is pretty unhealthy looking right now, and we'll actually look close up and show you how to identify this type of injury because it really is very easy to identify. So here I'm actually looking at a plant that I think is a pretty good example of what this kind of injury might look like. So oftentimes we'll see it kind of on the first few leaves, and if we look up close, it's got a really unique pattern of injury. So a lot of things can cause what we call interveinal leaf chlorosis. So where the space that in this leaf is actually green may be yellow, or it could actually die, so that would be necrosis. But with the Fomesafen carryover, we actually see that the leaf veins themselves will actually turn chlorotic, and then they can die. So then they, in some cases, when it affects the midrib, a sort of characteristic look is that the leaf will kind of bend over. And so if I pan up here, you can kind of see that these plants, they just look kind of wilty. And these ones have some pretty significant injury to them. So time will really tell whether or not some of these plants, like over here, some of them are pretty curled up, whether these are actually going to pull out of this. The root systems are really healthy, so that's some good news. We're getting some sun now. Things will be kind of stressful here with some hot weather, but hopefully the majority of these plants are going to make this through and not have an issue. In fact, it's very unusual for me to see this type of injury and actually see very much plant death with it, so I expect that most of these are going to be okay.